Today my topic is autoimmunity. I am assistant professor in Department of Pathology, Medical College, Surat. My learning objective of today's session is, first we discuss about general overview of immune system, then mechanism of immune tolerance. So it is important to discuss this before we come on actual topic of autoimmunity. And last learning objective is pathogenesis of autoimmune disorders or autoimmunity. So now first, what is immunity? So immunity, it is a basically defense mechanism which protect us from various pathogenic antigens or many pathogens like bacteria, virus, protozoa, etc. So basically it is a defense mechanism which protect us from harmful foreign substances. So now what are the types of immunity? So immunity is divided into innate immunity and adaptive immunity. And adaptive immunity again divided into humoral immunity and cellular immunity. What is innate immunity? So innate immunity, it is a defense mechanism that is already present in our body before the birth or even before infection. So it has a various components like epithelial cells, subepithelial lymphocytes, mast cells, monocytes and pattern recognized receptors like toll-like receptors, node-like receptors, C-type lectin receptors and Rig-like receptors. All these pattern-associated receptors which bind with the pathogen onto the surface of various cells like lymphocytes. And these receptors activates the various cytokines by help of NFK beta and interferon regulatory factors. So which is activated by engagement of these toll-like receptors. Then node-like receptors, engagement of these node-like receptor induce synthesis of interleukin-1 beta. And C-type lectin receptors, it detect the fungal glycans. And Rig-like receptor, it produce antiviral cytokines. So all these cytokines are released by engagement of these surface receptors. Then second is cell-mediated immunity. So it is a type of adaptive immune response. So it has a two category, cell-mediated immunity and humoral immunity. So when the innate immune system is fails to combat or fight against the foreign antigen, then role of adaptive immune system is very crucial. So whenever pathogen come in contact with any cells, it is taken up by the antigen presenting cell. So there are various cells are there which play a role as antigen presenting cell, like dendritic cell which is present in subepithelial tissue of the skin. And after the binding with this antigen presenting cell, these dendritic cells migrate to the draining lymph nodes. While this migration, these dendritic cells get matured and it express high level of MHC molecules onto their surface and expression of the co-stimulators. So this is very important. So whenever a dendritic cell carries harmful foreign antigens, only during that time the expression of co-stimulators are more and also there is a high level of MHC molecules. When this dendritic cell carries self-antigen, so there is no expression of co-stimulators. Then these protein antigens digested into the antigen presenting cells and it is degraded as peptide antigens and it bind with MHC molecules. And this, after binding with these MHC molecules, these antigen peptides are presented onto the surface of antigen presenting cell. Antigens that are ingested from the extracellular environment are processed in endosomes and lysosomal vesicles and it is displayed by class 2 MHC molecules and it is recognized by CD4 plus T cells. Antigen in the cytoplasm are displayed by class 1 MHC molecules and that are recognized by CD8 plus cytotoxic T lymphocyte. These CD8 plus T cells converted into cytotoxic T lymphocytes and kill the infected cells via granzyme pathway. And CD4 plus T cells converted into helper T cells like TH1, TH2 and TH17 secretes various cytokines which further activate CD4 plus T cells and mast cells. Various cytokines release produce inflammatory reactions, and this inflammatory reactions is further followed by opsonization and phagocytosis of the harmful foreign antigen. So this is how the cell mediated immunity works. In humoral immunity, what happens? In that, activation of the B lymphocytes which lead to antibody formation. So activated lymphocytes converted into plasma cell, and plasma cell secretes various kind of antibodies like IgM, IgG and IgE. All these antibodies form, either they neutralize the antigen or activate the complement pathway, and it also lead to opsonization and phagocytosis of the harmful foreign antigen or any pathogen. So this is how humoral immunity works. So ultimately this immune system protects us from various harmful foreign organism. But immunity is like a two-edged sword. So on one edge it protects us from the various harmful pathogens, but on other side various disorders are related to immune abnormality in the immune mechanism or immune systems, like hypersensitivity reactions. So what happens in hypersensitivity reactions? There is exaggerated immune response which ultimately destroys self tissues. Another kind of abnormality in immune system is autoimmunity. So what happens in autoimmunity? Our immune systems react against the self antigen. So it is normally not there, but in certain conditions immune system starts to react with self antigen and produces a autoimmune reactions. So now coming to one autoimmunity, what is autoimmunity? So it is a state in which immune system fails to distinguish between self and non-self antigen and react against own antigen presented by own antigen presenting cell and destroy them. So that is autoimmunity. Here self antigen is presented by antigen presenting cell, and immune system identify this antigen and start immune reactions and destroy it. So that is autoimmunity or autoimmune reaction. So autoimmune disease can be a organ specific, involve only one particular organ, or it can be a multi-organ disease, involve many organ at the same time. Autoimmune disease is associated with development of multiple autoantibodies or T cell mediated reactions against the self antigen. Normally, normal persons are unresponsive to their own or self antigen, so that is known as a self tolerance. And autoimmunity is results from failure of such self tolerance mechanism. So protective mechanism against self antigen is already existed in our body. So whenever failure in this protective mechanism or self tolerance, autoimmunity develops. Immune tolerance, so it is an unresponsiveness of lymphocyte to any antigen exposure. So there is no immune reactions, no activation, no effector mechanism and no any reactions. Self tolerance, so it is a lack of responsiveness to an individual's own antigen. So there are certain mechanisms are there in our body which prevent reactions against the self antigen. So there are two mechanisms, self tolerance which present in central lymphoid organ, and in peripheral organs it is a peripheral tolerance. So why we need to discuss this? Because we have to understand what are the exact mechanism which prevent reactions against the self antigen. Central tolerance, so it is a process in which receptors of immune immature T or B cells recognize their self antigen during maturation in central lymphoid organ and they are killed or rendered harmless. So in developing T cells, somatic rearrangements generates diverse T cell receptors. Many of these T cell receptors express high affinity for the self antigens. So in central organs, certain immature cells are developed which have a high affinity for self antigen. When T cell receptor of immature lymphocytes bind with self antigen, and these cells are destroyed by apoptosis. So this mechanism is known as a negative selection or deletion. So whatever the self antigen identified by self reactive cells within the central lymphoid organ, they are destroyed by apoptosis, that is negative selection. So this process of negative selection eliminates harmful self-reactive T lymphocytes from the T cell pool in central lymphoid organ. So it is not necessary that all self-reactive T lymphocytes is present. So certain antigens are present in central lymphoid organ, but many of these self antigens are not present in central lymphoid organ. So one protein known as a autoimmune regulator. So what it does? It stimulates the expression of some peripheral tissue restricted self antigen in the thymus. And this is a very crucial for deletion of the immature T cells in central and or primary lymphoid organ. So this autoimmune regulator, so it presents the peripheral tissue restricted self antigen into the central lymphoid organ. And after binding with this self antigen of peripheral tissue, autoreactive T cells are destroyed in central lymphoid organ. So this is for T lymphocyte. But for B lymphocytes, immature B lymphocytes, another mechanism is there, and that is known as a receptor editing. So what happens in receptor editing? The immature B cells that recognize self antigen in bone marrow undergo rearrangement of antigen receptor gene and then express new set of receptors which are not self reactive. So receptor is modified, and this receptor not bind with self antigen. So there is no immune reactions against self antigen. But if the receptor editing not occur, in that case the self reactive B cells die by apoptosis after binding with self antigen, and thus the self reactive B lymphocytes is removed from the mature pool. So this is the diagram which shows receptor editing. So in bone marrow, when immature B cell, self-reactive immature B cell encounter with self-antigen, so it undergo apoptosis. But due to some genetic rearrangement, different sets of receptors are produced which have not affinity for self-antigens, and these cells are get matured and entered into the cell pool. So that is receptor editing. But the process of deletion of self-reactive lymphocyte is not perfect in central colonies. Why? So as we discuss, what happens in central lymphoid organ? Self-reactive T lymphocyte or B lymphocytes react with self-antigen and it die by apoptosis. So autoimmune regulator in case of T cell presents some peripheral tissue restricted antigen into the thymus, and after presenting these antigens of peripheral tissue, autoreactive T cells are destroyed. But it is not necessary that every peripheral tissue restricted antigens like this presented by this autoimmune regulator. So this antigen may present in peripheral tissue, and self-reactive T lymphocytes against this antigen may escape from this central organ and it produces the autoimmune reaction in peripheral organs. Similar kind of escape it is also seen in B cells in bone marrow. So in that case, another mechanism is there to prevent autoimmune reaction, and that is known as a peripheral tolerance. So peripheral tolerance, it has a four mechanism. First is clonal energy. Second is suppression by regulatory T cells. Third one is activation induced cell death. And fourth one is antigen sequestration. First is clonal energy. So it is defined as a functional inactivation of lymphocytes after exposure to self antigen. So whenever T cells activated by foreign antigen, so it produces immune reactions. But certain mechanism, certain conditions are there to start immune reactions. So in normal situation, what happens? When peripheral or non-self antigen is presented by antigen presenting cell, so it generated two signals which is required for immune reaction. Signal one is produced when the T cell receptor bind with foreign antigen which is presented by MHC molecule of which present on antigen presenting cell. So after binding, this signal one is generated. And second signal is generated when the CD28 receptor which are present on T lymphocyte, it bind with co-stimulator which are present on antigen presenting cell like CD80 or 86. After binding co-stimulator with this CD28, generate the second signal, and both two signals are required to start immune reaction. What happens when self antigen is presented by antigen presenting cell? So here what happens when antigen presenting cell presents self antigen to the T cell receptor, after binding this T cell receptor with T cell self antigen, signal 1 is produced, but signal 2 is not produced, because when antigen presenting cell presents self antigen, here co-stimulators are not that much as compared to presentation with foreign antigen. So here co-stimulator level is very low. And second thing is, there is another molecules receptor present on the T cell receptor known as a CTLA-4. So in normal situation, the affinity of CTLA-4 is more as compared to CD28. So when self antigen is presented, at that time CTLA-4 bind with CD80 and 86. So second signal is not delivered. So there is no immune reactions, no activation of the T lymphocytes. So this is known as energy. So here cells are engaged with antigen, self antigen, but it not produce any immune reaction. So it prevent the autoimmune reaction. Second mechanism is suppression by regulatory T cells. Regulatory T cells develop in thymus as a result of recognition of self antigen. So it is a central tolerance. So at that time, regulatory T cells are generated in central lymphoid organ. These regulatory T cells are CD4 plus T cells. It express high level of CD25, alpha chain of interleukin-12, interleukin-2 and FOXP3 receptor for their normal development and functioning. These regulatory T cells secrete immunosuppressive cytokines like interleukin-10 and TGF-beta which inhibit lymphocyte activation and its effector functions. So this is another mechanism by which autoimmune reaction can be prevented. Regulatory T cells also express CTLA-4 which bind to co-stimulator BC1 molecule of antigen presenting cell and inhibit co-stimulation or inhibit second signal. Regulatory T cells also play a role in acceptance of the fetus. So here what happens? There is FOXP3 expression is there during the placentation of the fetus. So whatever the paternal antigen is there, it is foreign to the mother. So it can elicit the immune reactions. But due to presence of this FOXP3 gene, so such reaction not occurs and it is increase the acceptance of the fetus. But whenever there is genetic alteration in FOXP3 which result in recurrent abortion. Then third mechanism is activation induced cell death. CD4 plus T cells that recognize self antigen may receive signal that promote their death by apoptosis. So this is a similar kind of mechanism which are observed in central lymphoid organ. Once they identify self antigen and these self-reactive T cells receive the signal that promote their death by apoptosis by two pathways. First is activation of the pro-apoptotic member of the BCL family. It is known as a BIM, which induce apoptosis by mitochondrial pathway. And second is activation induced cell death of CD4 plus T cells, which lead to apoptosis by FAS-FAS ligand system, means activation of the CD95 molecule. So this apoptosis develops. Fourth mechanism is antigen sequestration. Some of the self antigen are effectively kept separated from the immune system by sequestrations, which do not communicate with the blood and lymph. So as a result, self antigen in such tissue fails to elicit any immune reaction. So examples are vitreous humor of the eye and sperm in seminiferous tubules. So in these organs, antigen are kept separated from circulation or lymphatics. So there is no exposure to such antigens. So there is no antibody formation or no any immune reaction. Now coming to an autoimmune disorder. So first we discuss what is immunity. Second is immune tolerance, central tolerance and peripheral tolerance. All these mechanisms, both the central tolerance and peripheral tolerance, is important to prevent the escape of self-reactive T cells to the peripheral organ. But in certain conditions, these self-reactive T cells escape from this immune preventive immune mechanism and produce autoimmune disorders. Autoimmunity arises from a combination of the inheritance of susceptibility genes, which may contribute to the breakdown of the self-tolerance, environmental triggers such as infections, tissue damage, which promote the activation of the self-reactive T or B lymphocytes and produce autoimmune disorders. Many susceptibility genes and environmental triggers cause changes that contribute to the development of the autoimmune disease, like defective tolerance or regulation of the tolerance mechanism, abnormal display of the self-antigens. So sometimes there is a modification and structural changes of self-reactive antigens occurs, and it is escape from the tolerance mechanism and produce autoimmune reaction. What is the pathogenesis of autoimmunity? So there may be genetic alteration in various genes like MHC, HLA and non-MHC genes, and there is a definite role of some infections. So it produces epitope spreading, upregulation of the co-stimulators, molecular mimicry and release of the sequestered antigens into the periphery. So these are the basic mechanism of autoimmune reaction or diseases. Role of susceptibility genes. Autoimmune reactions are complex multigenic disorders. Many HLA and MHC genes are associated with autoimmune disease. The exact mechanism is not well understood how it produces the autoimmune disorders, but it is thought that MHC genes can affect the process of negative selection of the T cells that react with the self antigens are allowed to develop and mature. So it may affect the negative selection process of central tolerance. So this chart shows few autoimmune disorders and their association with the HLA alleles, like rheumatoid arthritis, type 1 diabetes mellitus, multiple sclerosis, SLE, ankylosing spondylitis and celiac disease. To have a definite evidence that these diseases are associated with various HLA alleles. Then several non-MHC loci are associated with autoimmune disorders, like polymorphism in the gene called PTPN22, which encode a protein tyrosine phosphatase, are associated with rheumatoid arthritis and type 1 diabetes. Polymorphism in the gene for NOD2 are associated with Crohn's disease. Polymorphism in gene encoding interleukin 2 receptors and interleukin 7 receptors Alpha chain are associated with multiple sclerosis and other autoimmune diseases. Then mutation in individual genes. Mutation of immune regulatory protein gene like autoimmune regulator, it cause failure of expression of many peripheral self antigen in thymus. So this is important. So normal function is AIRE is present a peripheral restricted tissue antigen, self antigen to the central lymphoid organ. So in normal mechanism, this AIRE produce a self antigen of peripheral tissue into the central lymphoid organ, and self-reactive T cells are die by apoptosis by binding with this antigen. But whenever there is mutation of this AIRE, so it fails to present this or those antigen into the central lymphoid organ, and it result in autoimmune disorder. Second is mutation of FAS-FAS gene. So again, it inhibit the apoptosis and cells are survived, autoreactive T cells are survived and released into peripheral organs. Then mutation of CTLA-4. So normally CTLA-4 bind with co-stimulator in normal situations or when antigen present self-antigen. But whenever there is mutation of this CTLA-4 gene, so co-stimulator signals inhibition is washed out and it produces autoimmune reactions. Then similar mutation of FOXP3 gene again induce the various autoimmune disorders. So this is a diagram shows upregulation of the co-stimulator on antigen presenting cell. So whenever self antigen are present by this antigen presenting cell, so there is no expression of co-stimulators or they are weakly expressed and do not produce any immune reactions after binding with T cell receptor. Whenever there is an infection occurs and these microbes enter into this antigen presenting cell and it is processed and is enhance the expression of this co-stimulator on antigen presenting cell. So the cells, antigen presenting cells which have self antigen, they have also developed co-stimulators due to this infection. And these antigen presenting cells then bind with this self-reactive T cell. And this CD28 bind with co-stimulator which are upregulated by presence of another infectious agents. And this starts autoimmune disorder. Then second mechanism is molecular mimicry. So certain viral antigen, they bind with T cell receptor or B cell receptor and they activate the immune systems and effector cells are produced. And these effector cells, they either their receptor or antibody, they can bind with cell tissue whose molecular structure is similar to that of infectious agent or antigen. And this antibody or molecules which are generated from these effector cells bind with the cell tissue and it causes the destruction of the own tissue and produce autoimmune disorder. Rheumatic fever. So it is a classic example of molecular mimicry. So what happens in rheumatic fever? Group A streptococci present in throat infections express M protein. The large amount of IgG is produced against this M protein by the plasma cell. And this IgG bind with molecules which are present on cardiac myocyte, structure of which is similar to M protein of streptococci. And it result in antibody induced cardiac injury and it is produced rheumatic heart disease. So this is a classic example of molecular mimicry. So here antibody develops against the M protein but it cross react with the cardiac myocyte because structural similarity are there between M protein and molecules which are present on cardiac myocyte. Then polyclonal activation of the B cells. Some viruses like Epstein-Barr virus and HIV cause polyclonal activation of the B cell, which may result in production of the antibodies and autoantibodies, so which can react with the many cell tissues and it causes autoimmune disorder. Then damage to immunologically privileged sites, so like brain, eye, testes and fetus in uterine cavity. So all these are immunologically privileged sites, because antigen which are present on these sites, they are kept separated from the rest of the peripheral organ. But whenever there is any damage to these organs, what happens? Antigens which are kept separated are liberated from these organs and it is carried out into the circulation. So in circulation, what happens? Immune reactions are started. Effector cells are produced against this antigen. And these effector cells or antibodies which are produced against this antigen, they enter into these immunologically privileged sites and elicit the immune reactions. So that is another mechanism of autoimmune disorders. So autoimmunity or pathogenesis of autoimmune disorder. So it is a multi-complex mechanism. So there are role of susceptibility genes, role of infections, role of tissue damage. So all these tissue which are damaged, they are cross-reacted with self-reactive T cells. And these self-reactive T cells starts destroying tissue of the own structures and it induces the autoimmune disorders. So there are few examples of autoimmune disorders. They can be organ specific or they may be systemic. So localized autoimmune disorders, it can affect particular organs like endocrine gland, hematological system, GI tract. So it produces the various localized immune disorders. But certain disorders, they are known as a systemic autoimmune disorders like SLE, rheumatoid arthritis, Sjogren syndrome, systemic sclerosis. They simultaneously involve the multiple organs. So that is known as a systemic autoimmune disorders. So lastly, in summary, immunological tolerance to self-antigen is a peculiarity of immune systems, and breakdown of this immune tolerance result in autoimmune disorders. Central tolerance recognize self-antigen in central lymphoid organs, and peripheral tolerance mechanism recognize self-antigen in peripheral tissue and they are removed from the circulation. But the failure of this cell tolerance, so it liberates the antigen or self-reactive T cells into the peripheral organs. Then inheritance of the susceptibility genes like MSC molecule, HLA. So certain genetic variations are there which are associated with these autoimmune disorders. Then infections. So it may produce molecular mimicry or it may cause upregulation of the co-stimulators which are not normally present. And various environmental factors. These are the responsible for various autoimmune disorders. So, ultimately, whenever there is any breach in the immune self-tolerance mechanism, and if it is associated with certain environmental factors like infectious agents, then only autoimmune disorders can develop. So, my references is, I took material from Pathologic Basis of Disease, 9th edition, and textbook of pathology and other various internet sources. So thank you for listening.